Yo, what's good, guys? It's Nightwing2303 from WearTesters.com. Today, we've got a quick, detailed look and review of these bad boys right here. This is the Curry 3-0 by Under Armour. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get right into it. So the first video I made of these, they were as big as my shoulder width. They were a size 16. It was the limited white and gold colorway. It was actually Anthony Tolliver's personal pair. He made a brief cameo in the video, which is kind of cool. He actually really likes the shoe. I really like the shoe too, visually. I have not played in them just yet though, so I do not know about the performance. Although a lot of the performance features are very similar to the original Curry 3, so I think that a lot of it will be similar, but you never know until you take them out for a spin. You can see the traction hasn't changed whatsoever, and then the tooling itself is the same substance or the same materials basically as the Curry 3, but it's just shaped a little bit differently. I actually like the way that these look a little bit more, the less bulky heel and stuff like that. Even though I like the bulky heel, I love the gradient fade and the splatter print. You got two of the things that I absolutely love on one midsole. Totally killer. Something that has been confusing a lot of customers from Under Armour's products, or just, you know, people in general, is the use of Micro G. If you have not seen it already, we did a Know Your Tech on the Curry 3, and on that video it was stated that the midsole itself is Micro G, and then in the heel there's a little crash pad of charged cushion. That was confirmed by Under Armour. I double checked. I was like, yo, are you guys sure? Because this don't feel like Micro G. And recently I was in Chicago at the NBA Combine with Under Armour, and I just was flat out like, yo, like, can you please explain to me what happened to Micro G? Because it does not feel like any Micro G that I ended up loving in like the original clutch fit, the Micro G torch and shoes like that. So they said that basically what they've done is they've kind of like redefined the compound that they've done with the materials or the foam, and they've made it so that they have a more of a firmer setup for a carrier, but charge is just a different version, kind of, you know, different foam mixture and stuff like that. And so that's kind of what they're going with. So these do actually use a Micro G carrier. They just don't feel like Micro G. They don't feel like the original Micro G. So if you played in some of the older Micro G models and then you play in these, you obviously will notice a difference, and that's just kind of where they're at. So it is Micro G. It's just kind of like what they're calling their EVA compound. Nike has Phylon. Adidas just calls it EVA and stuff, but they also have their like tweaked versions like the Adiprene Plus, and Under Armour says Micro G. So that's just kind of what it is. And the upper here is similar but different. So the 3 was threadborne and then it had fuse overlays. This is just a mesh with fuse overlays. They feel very similar on foot, so I'm pretty sure that they're gonna play pretty similar. The only thing that I'm not liking though is just this gigantic piece of fuse on the toe that is like in a flex zone. I don't really like that. It's real thin and stuff, so it shouldn't like disconnect from the foot too badly, but I'm having that feeling like when I put them on that when I flex that this is kind of like bulging one way when I want it to move with my foot. So I think this should have been real slim, kind of like it was on the 3, maybe even just a rand and stuff like that, like a toe cap. So that's the only piece of the shoe that I'm not liking right off the bat, but hopefully it doesn't, you know, perform badly or anything like that, but we'll find out soon enough. And then probably the biggest change between these and the original 3s is the back collar area right here. So you can see that it's kind of independent, but kind of not. This area right here is meant for if you wear a brace, you're able to lock yourself in there easily without having to like be like real constricted within the shoe. Sometimes when you wear a brace, you have to actually go up half a size just because the brace fills out a lot of that heel area. This area is just kind of articulated, I guess you can call it, so that it'll move with the brace itself. And that pretty much takes care of everything. I will be testing these quickly and giving them a performance review. Like I said, I don't expect them to be too much different than the 3, so hopefully they're not. The prices drop between the 3 and these as well. These are $120, which I think is the perfect price point for Curry shoe. I just think that they shouldn't be any higher or lower. I think that that's perfect. And let me know what you guys think about these down below in the comment section. Do you like them? Do you not? Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Stay tuned for the performance view, and until next time, guys, have a good one.